Welcome to a journey through the history of art. We will travel along a timeline from the caves to the 19th century. My name is Dr. Jean Ouellette. Let's begin by making the familiar unfamiliar. Going to the market, the art market. If the French kings were supporting French artists in the quest for cultural dominance, then, a few hundred miles to the north, an entirely different art culture emerged. The New Republic, the Netherlands, could not be more of a contrast to the absolute ruler, the Sun King Louis XIV of France. Freed from the yoke of Spanish rule, the Dutch were a Protestant republic without a prominent aristocratic class, and they had an elected ruler. Also called Holland, after one of the important provinces, this tiny nation was one of the richest in Europe. A seafaring people who enlarged their territory at home by claiming the land from the sea, the Dutch developed a vast empire in trade, stretching across the globe. The Dutch artist was in a historically unique position, lacking all the important patrons available elsewhere in Europe. The Protestant churches purged themselves of decoration. There was no monarchy, nothing to advertise. But there were middle-class buyers with comfortable incomes who wanted their lives and their accomplishments to be recorded. The Dutch artists responded by creating in an ad hoc fashion something new called an art market, a business for artists who customized their wares, mostly paintings. Genres of different kinds of subject matter began to emerge. In contrast to the glory of history painting, the pomp of formal portraiture, Dutch artists recorded the tidy and neat landscapes, the scrubbed city streets, the immaculate interiors, the solid and somber citizens, and the sparse, bare churches, now cleansed of popish splendor. Dutch painting was an encyclopedia of life in the Netherlands, from the well-to-do to the bawdy inhabitants. The still lives are inventories of trade and wealth of Holland at the peak of its power. The small paintings were sold to private clients in a commercial market. The larger commissions were done for the numerous public organizations and militias. There was so much business for artists that there was room for some women. Rachel Roche became a renowned painter of flowers. Judith Lester painted genre scenes of everyday life from a woman's point of view. But the Dutch art market was a phenomenon dependent upon surplus wealth and middle-class buyers, economic conditions that would not exist in the rest of Europe for another 200 years. Although most of the continent was under the command and control of religious and secular absolutism during the 17th and 18th centuries, the Dutch experiment would not be forgotten. It is perhaps no coincidence that when economic and social conditions in France began to resemble that of the Dutch during their empire period, that the French artist, the realist Courbet and Manet, looked back to the artist of the Netherlands, the once and future artists of everyday life.